I'm a theater director, opera director, occasionally working in dance, occasionally working in film. And part of my work has always been very concerned with how new and emerging technologies can be incorporated into live performance. I tend to think that on some level we become more human when we manage to find more reasonable ways to work with machines. We're trying to figure out if we could teach robots to improvise. Can they anticipate movement? Can they make decisions about interesting movement?
So I'm Julie. I lead the Interactive Robotics Lab as a part of the Computer Science and Artificial Intelligence Laboratory, and we develop robots that work better with people. We look at trying to give the robot a model or an understanding how it is people behave on their own, but especially in teams. So we actually deploy collaborative robots on factory floors to work alongside people to build planes and build cars. In this project, it's a completely different angle.
I suggested that we maybe have a look at dance. I noticed that a lot of our vocabularies were the same. A lot of the way they talk about joint action is very similar to how we talk about improvisation. We were fortunately able to take advantage of a relationship with Boston Ballet so that we could work with dancers who have a super advanced understanding of joint action, ensemble performance, and improvisation. Working with these virtuosic performers alongside newcomers to the field. What was really interesting, really important for us was also to look at learning and how quickly both groups learn from one another. That provides us with a really broad dynamic of movement and a broad dynamic of data.
Really, the question for us is what's similar and what's different about the improvisation of working alongside someone to do assembly type work or dance? So it's almost like trying to codify this beautiful artistic process. What we'll learn is hopefully something fundamental about what it means for people to learn to collaborate, not just in a factory setting, but in many other facets of our lives.
Can I imagine 2,000 people in a major production with AR headsets on? Yes, I can. And it's possible that this will make way for a really super dynamic live experience, something that we maybe haven't seen so much of before.